trying to bunt his way on to open the ball game, but he misses it for strike one.
First pitch, 107.
Verlander's ready. Here's the 0-1. Now a check swing, but he holds up in time. Ball one.
Well, that's a huge difference between being 0-2 and 1-1 as a hitter, especially against a guy like this on the mound. So that's a good job to hold up on that pitch.
Fastball swung on and missed, and the leadoff man is gone on strikes to start the afternoon. Kyle Schwarber will stand in as he'll get a break from playing the field and be the DH here in this one.
Yeah, it's a nice luxury to have here in an interleague ballgame. You give him a little bit of a break from the field, but you still keep that big bat in the lineup.
Line towards center field. That gets down, and he's got himself a base hit.
You think he was looking for a fastball there? I think he was. That's about as hard a hit ball as you're going to see, and he was right on that one.
Chris Bryant takes his first shot here with the runner at first now and one away. Couldn't hold up on the curveball there as he went around for strike one. Runner at first here, one man out. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Oh, and you can tell by these first couple swings, he's not just looking to poke one through the right side of the infield. He's looking to put something into orbit.
Anthony Rizzo set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away.
Yeah, and he's going to have to find a gap to give that man on first a chance to score.
And, ooh, I'm not sure you can get fooled worse than that. It's 0-1.
Yeah, he really pulled off of that one, and that's not the kind of swing we're accustomed to seeing from a guy like him.
Especially starting off an at-bat.
Chopped down the first baseline, but it's a foul ball, says the first base umpire. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Nothing doing against Verlander that time around. And now the Tigers. Jake Arrieta gets the starting nod for the Cubs in this one. What's your take on him, EK?
Well, guys, remember, he's not a lot of fun to face because he's got five pitches. As a hitter, you've got to worry about the ball coming in, moving away, the speed. He's a lot to handle when you're up at the plate.
Right side. And that is through into right field for a single.
So far, so good. They get a scoreless top of the first, and now a leadoff single to start things in their half.
Runners on the move for second. And here's a ball hit in the air. Calling for it, Bryant. One away. And it's not in time as he's in well ahead of the throw. A moment now in Motown to check out the Tigers' starting lineup. Steve, what's the key for him against one of the best starters in the game?
Well, you're going to get a heavy dose of those sinking fastballs, so you've got to look for the ball to get up in the zone. If you swing at anything down, you're going to be rolling over pitches, and it's hard to get a rally started if you're hitting in the double plays all day.
Batting fourth, right fielder,
J.D. Martinez. Bats now and will try to start over with the bases empty and two away following the RBI ground out.
And all he's looking for right now is a pitch that he can drive somewhere. You got to get on base and preferably in scoring position so maybe he can get his teammates to drive him in.
And boy, this at-bat is not starting off well as he's behind 0-2 now.
He's just having all kinds of trouble up there.
Swing and a miss. Blew the fastball right by him in the inning. Ben Zobrist makes his way to the plate. He'll get us started here in the top of the second.
Ben Zobrist.
And a check swing here, but he clearly went around on a pitch that would have been a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. And it's quickly 0-2. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Oh, and he misses it. And a diving try in left, but he can't come up with it.
Batting six.
Yeah, it looked like a fairly routine play there. Don't know if he took his eye off it or what, but he winds up basically whiffing on the catch, and that's going to wind up a two-base error.
So stepping in, Addison Russell, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Pitch swung on and missed. The throw is in time as he gets the tag down, and he's out trying to take third. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good.
Well, one thing you're taught at an early age, when you see a pitch coming in tight, do not open yourself up. You've got to turn your back into it to protect yourself. This will still hurt, but it could have been worse.
And now he'll step off quickly and look the runner back. And he may have thought something was on here as he stepped off to look back to first. Now a quick move here to step off and look the runner back. Stepping in now, number 40, as Verlander jumps ahead of him here with strike one. Goodness, 0-2 now.
Oh, man, what a perfect pitch right there in a perfect spot. And that's exactly how you have to attack a guy like this. He wasn't even close on that pitch.
Verlander pauses. 0-2 on its way. And this is right by Saltalamacchia to the backstop. Thought about going for second, but instead, now they've got him in a pickle. Jason Hayward set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away. He's running towards second. Pitch swung on and missed. The throw. Here's the 0-1. Snap throw from the catcher. Looking for the strikeout, here's the 0-2 pitch. Now a swing and a fly ball. Upton on the move. And this will fall, but it's a foul ball. Here comes the nothing and two pitch. Got him looking, and that ends the inning. Victor Martinez will lead things off here as they'll have 5, 6, and 7 due up to start the home second. Boy, not the way he wanted to start out here. It's 0-1.
I'll tell you what, it's tough to try and outthink this guy out there. Seems like whatever pitch he throws, you're stuck looking for something else.
And he lays off for ball one.
Well, that was a no-brainer there. If a guy misses that poorly on a curveball, you got to throw him another one. That was better recognition there.
And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2.
Well, I'd be surprised if they'd go back to the curve again on 2-2. He's had a couple of pretty good looks at it at the plate.
popped high in the air. Bryant on the move. He's got it one away.
Batting six.
Now to the plate, Nick Castellanos, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Baez with the bare hand. He's out.
Oh, what a play. And you know, sometimes these guys make it look so easy, we forget how difficult it is to make a play like that. Not only did he bare hand this ball, but he also made a sweet throw on the run over to first base. So often you'll see a guy airmail or short hop a throw like that because of the bad grip you have on the ball. But not in this case. That's a nice play.
Justin Upton is in with two away as he takes a ball 1-0.
And we're going to see a lot more of this because this is a guy who's let it be known that he will work inside. He'll even back you off the plate if he has to.
Little late that time as he swings and misses for strike one.
A lot of people think that pitch will burn straight down, but it will work back a little bit towards righties, like that one did right there.
Swing and a miss as it's dropped behind the plate. Number 40 is after it, but the throw is late, so the inning will continue after the strikeout pitch gets away. And the throw takes off on him.
Oh!
And not what he wanted to do there, as now they'll need four outs to get out of this inning. Jared Saltalamacchia set to take his first cuts with a man at first and two away. Now here's a ball hit in the air to straightaway right field. This ball's got plenty of carry to it, and it is out of here. A two-run blast to straightaway right field, and the Tigers take a 3-0 lead.
And this is where these guys can be so dangerous. They've got power all throughout the lineup. When the number eight hitter's taking you deep, you know there's no easy outs.
Here's Cameron Maben now, as he'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. And that finds its way through for a base hit. And he's in there safely. He's got a double. Jose Iglesias will stand in. He singled to lead off the home first.
Good job of going the other way. Almost felt like he was looking to go the other way, trying to drive it to the opposite field.
And in fact, no throw as he's into third easily. And he's going to make it up to third here as he advances on the wild pitch. A man on third with two down. Now the runner breaks for the plate. And the squeeze was on, but this one will get foul. 0-2, here it comes. And here's a ball hit in the air. Bryant in foul ground, and they can't run it down. Set to deliver on nothing and two, here it comes. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Swing and a miss, and that ends the inning. Javier Baez steps in here to start out their half of the third, top of the order to follow.
Yeah, and you know, he's the number nine hitter, but you've got to go to the plate right now thinking like a leadoff guy. Just find a way to get on base and then give those 1-2-3 guys a chance to drive in or do something.
Dexter Fowler will dig in for a second time, a strikeout victim opening up the ballgame. Couldn't quite pull that swing back. He went around for strike one. Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control 0-2. Runs up and gets this one down. On to first by Saltalamacchia, and the sacrifice is a good one. Kyle Schwarber will dig in. He singled his first time around.
And they take another single right here, too, no doubt. Runner in scoring position, so any ball into the outfield probably gets him home.
Starts to go around here, but it doesn't matter. This is strike two anyway. And a swing and a miss, and another punch out here. Six already, and that's out number two. Chris Bryant is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Behind on that one, now behind in the count, 0-1. Hit the other way out toward right field. Martinez on the run. He can't get there, so the inning will continue. The relay, and they've got the runner hung up between first and second. And he is in there.
Now, I got to tell you, I love the way this guy just lets it rip. Ahead in the count, behind in the count. It really doesn't matter to this guy. He's just going to go up hacking. And he drives in a run right here as he just drills this one for two bases.
Anthony Rizzo stands in now. High in the air out to center field. Maven is there. And that retires the side. Cubs pick up a run on the RBI double. We play 2.5. It's the Tigers 3 and the Cubs 1. Ian Kinsler will start things off in the inning for Detroit. He'll be followed by Miguel Cabrera waiting on deck.
And they jumped out to that early lead, so now it's all about just adding on.
Sends that one out of play for strike one. Arrieta gets the sign. Here he comes, 0-1. And there's a swing and a miss as Kinsler's down quickly now, 0-2.
Down 0-2 after two great sliders. He's got his work cut out for him now.
Chop foul at the plate and we'll do it again. To short. Russell's got it. Throw to first is in time for the first out.
The first baseman.
So one away, and that'll bring in Miguel Cabrera. Hit sharply on the ground to the left. Throw on to first will take care of Cabrera for the second out.
The right fielder, number 28.
Digging in to try it again, J.D. Martinez. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Well, at the very least, he went down hacking. Striking out is one of the many frustrations that go along with hitting, and you have to accept that it's going to happen sometimes.
I had him lunging at that one out of the zone, and that's strike one.
And this would be a good bounce-back inning for him. He's looked a little shaky here in these first few innings, so a 1-2-3 inning would be just what the doctor ordered.
A ball and two strikes to count now with the bases empty and two away. Looking for the strikeout, here's the 1-2. Grounded back up the middle. Backhanded. Throw won't be in time as he reaches it first.
And here's a situation where, heck, just make contact. Put the ball in play. You never know. Winds up beating this ball out.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Into the seats, 0-1. Third inning here, 3-1 our score. Runner goes for second. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. On the move again from first to third. Bryant is up with it. And he's safe.
No, he's safe.
And they've got him hung up out there between second and third. But he gets back in time, safe at second base.
Well, definitely a throwing error that time. Let's check and see how tough that scoop was. You can see it's kind of right in that border area of whether to turn the glove or not, and he gets it wrong here.
Nick Castellanos now. Now both runners are breaking. Pitch swung on and missed the throw. And he'll just hang on as both runners move into scoring position now.
Yeah, a little surprising to see him try and pull this off with two away, but it took a chance that the guy on the mound was going to be too focused on throwing strikes here, and turns out they were right.
Second and third, two away. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
Boy, he just looks like he's swinging underwater, way behind those first two pitches.
Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And he will beat the throw home. It's a 4-1 score now. And it's in time, and he's out at the plate. So one runs across, but the second one is cut down trying to score.
Oh.
Leading off the inning, Ben Zobrist, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up.
And right here is an important time for them to climb back into this one. They definitely want to even this one up sooner rather than later.
And he gets him to swing through that one. He's in control 0-2. Jammed him a bit there as it's fouled at the plate. Popped up. Castellanos is over. One down.
Up next for the Cubs, shortstop
Addison Russell walks into the box after being hit by a pitch in his first appearance, and that has to be a little motivation to do something big right here.
And he knows there was no real intention to hit him right there, but that doesn't make you feel any better to get hit. He'll be looking to get some revenge right here.
And the throw to first will be in time, so they stamp out the bunt attempt.
Well, just from a distance standpoint, you have to remember that left-handed hitters maybe get a step or two advantage over a right-handed hitter leaving that batter's box. So that's why it's much easier for lefties to bunt their way on than it is for righties to do it. And here, he needed those two extra steps because that was a very close play down there at first.
Number 40 started to go around, but it's a called strike, 0-1. Verlander sets his sights, coming at him with the 0-1. Tries to drop one down here, but he misses, strike two. And a bunt attempt now, but this is foul and the inning is over. What was that all about? Three up. Justin Upton is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Left fielder.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Bonnie looks like he's swinging a garden hose out there as this is cut on and missed for strike one.
And for that guy right there, this is going to be an important inning. He's already given up four runs through three. And you know, they need to get a minimum of five, hopefully six innings out of him. So he needs to show something right here.
And he'll try and tempt him with one in the dirt, but he'll hold back here. It's 1-2. And this is swung on and missed. And this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout. And there's one away. Jared Saltalamacchia will try things again. He hit that two-run homer his first time.
Yeah, he absolutely crushed it earlier, so let's see if he can get into another one in this at-bat.
Now a swing and a fly ball. Zobrist giving chase, and that will end up a foul ball. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Not able to hold on there as he swings through a pitch in the dirt, and it doesn't look good for him now, down 0-2. And a slider gets away from him here as it just about got him in the ankle.
I'll say this, he wasn't going to get his arms extended on that one.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. Ground ball right side, straight into the shift. And that's through for a hit. Running hard, he's digging for second. Around second, he'll try for third. Oh, and he misses the stop sign there as he heads for the plate. Tried to make it home when he shouldn't have, and now they've got him hung up. And he will scramble back to third, but get there safely.
Well, he's going to get a base hit on the play, but that's when the real adventure begins. And by the time we're done, he's going to wind up at third on what will be ruled a single and an error.
Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And this is going to wind up a foul ball. Now the runner's on his way home. And they roll the dice with the squeeze, and he gets it down. Oh, and it eats him up a bit. And he's going to make it up to second base safely as he's in there. My word.
He can't believe it. I can't either. This ball doesn't even make it out of the infield, yet no one gets a glove on it. It's going to cost him a run.
Here's the shortstop now, Jose Iglesias. Fowler is there now, and he has it, two gone. Oh, and he runs right through the stop sign. Now a long throw home. And now they've got the runner caught in the hot box as he thought about going home. Maben rounds third, heading for the plate. Oh, and he can't get back to third. A blunder there rounding the bags, and the inning is over. Tigers get just the one. Leading off the inning, Jason Hayward. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Boy, they've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game. So just chip away, chip away.
And he pumps the fastball by him at 94. It's 0-2. And a check swing here, but the bat clearly breaks the plane as he set down for the first out.
Well, let's take a look at this check swing here in slow motion. From this speed, it almost always looks like the guy goes around. Here? Well, it looked like a good call down there at third base. I think that bat did break the plane, and that is a strike.
The batter number 24, center fielder
at the plate, Dexter Fowler. He successfully laid down a sack bunt in his last plate appearance.
Yeah, a well-executed bunt his last at-bat, but obviously this time he's swinging away.
Try to bunt for a base hit here as he gets this one down. But the throw will beat him at first, so the bunt for hit attempt is snuffed. Cubs are down in order. They're down 5-1. Ian Kinsler will dig in for a third time now. He's popped out and grounded out so far. Bunt attempt, but that'll bounce foul. Breaks his bat as this one's popped up, and he's retired one away. Miguel Cabrera will stand in again. A couple of groundouts for him on the ledger in his two trips so far.
Yeah, just sort of rolling over on it, guys. See if he can make a small adjustment and get through one here.
And he waves at a curveball there. No balls and a strike.
He's thrown a first pitch strike to around 90% of the batters he's faced, and yet he's getting lit up. I mean, you've got to throw first pitch strikes, but they can't be hittable.
Toward the gap in right center, this is going to be a base hit, and he may take that big turn at first. Around first, on his way to second now, Now Cabrera rounds second. He's going to try for three. Now a long throw to third. Oh, and he ignores the third base coach and heads for home. And the runner stuck in a pickle between third base and home. And they will tag him out in a rundown, and that is Bonehead City right there.
The right fielder, number 28.
J.D. Martinez steps in, working on a 1-for-2 game so far. A little tardy there. No balls and a strike. Here's a late swing and a miss. Strike two.
Well, a couple of good swings back to back, but nothing at all to show for it.
And here's a ball hit in the air. Hayward sprinting after it. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for Detroit. Kyle Schwarber will come in now to begin their half of the sixth, and it's been a struggle for them so far. Just three hits through the first five innings.
And that's certainly not going to be enough to get the job done. And as the scoreboard bears out, if they want to get back in this game, I think this is the inning that it needs to start happening.
Stepping in, Chris Bryant. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Boy, he had a great at-bat last time up, and he'll look for another pitch he can drive right here.
Swing and a high pop-up back onto the outfield grass now. Oh, and this deflects right off him. Anthony Rizzo will stand in now. He's struck out and flied out, 0-for-2 thus far. Runs up and gets this one down. On to first by Saltalamacchia, and the sacrifice is a good one.
Well, you know, he had a good idea right there. The infield was playing back, but it's not going to work out for him this time. That's a nice play, and they're going to take care of him at first.
And he'll be thrown out at first. So that didn't go quite according to plan, and with it, the inning is over. One left. Victor Martinez will stride in here to get the Tigers started in their half of the sixth. Here's a swing and a high pop-up. Drifting toward the third base dugout. Bryant is over and he puts it away for the first out.
The third baseman, number nine.
Nick Castellanos will try it again. He's grounded out and struck out in two trips.
Yep, not showing too much so far, but he's got a chance to make something happen right here. See if he can put those other ABs behind him.
Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-1. And not a real good cut at that slider, and he's behind 1-2.
Yeah, that's just the same pitch three times in a row. I guess he figures, why mess with success when you get it to 1-2?
Reached for and popped into the air back behind second. Here's Baez to make the catch, and that becomes out number two.
The left fielder, number eight.
And this is right where they wanted this thing. You see it on show track there? They wanted to take him up around the letters, hoping for the pop-up, and that's exactly what they got.
Here's Justin Upton now. As he goes after the first pitch and lines one out toward right center. Hayward is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Back here at Sportsman's Park, we're through the first six innings with the Tigers on top. And before we start the seventh, let's take a look at our game summary. Addison Russell stands in as he checks his swing here for strike one. Drilled right back up the middle. A dive, but he can't get a glove on it. It's through for a base hit. Number 40 will dig in now, just hoping to put one in play. 0-for-2 with a couple of strikeouts so far. And a dive in left, but he can't get it. It'll get by him toward the wall. The relay, and he is out, retreating to second as they slap the tag on him. Jason Hayward stands into the box. He's 0-for-2 so far in this one. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1. Yet again, another first pitch strike.
And it's a big reason of why he's having the success he is. You establish the count in your favor right away, and it just opens up the door to so many more options going forward.
And that'll get down for a base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one-out single. Javier Baez stands in. He got under one and popped out his last time up.
Yeah, he just uppercut a fastball. That top hand kind of dragged through the zone, which caused the bat head to drop a little bit.
First offering on its way. Oh, and a hearty cut there to begin the at-bat. It's nothing in one.
Kind of interesting to see how he's going to respond to this situation that he's worked himself into.
Yeah, he hasn't found himself in too many tough spots, but he's got one now.
The batter number 22.
Dexter Fowler will stand in, and they've done a good job keeping him off base at the top of the lineup. He's 0-for-3 thus far.
Yeah, guys, not really providing the spark that they usually hope to get out of him. Maybe he can make something happen right here.
First pitch hack in here, and that's the first strike.
Look at where we are in this game. Late innings, and this pitcher has thrown a first pitch strike to every hitter he's faced. You wonder why he's getting good results.
And another foul ball. Seventh inning here in a 5-1 ball game. He got him. And exhale as he's out of the jam and the inning is over. Cubs strand a couple. Jared Saltalamacchia will dig in again, and as he does, we'll flash you back to inning number two as you get a look at his two-run homer that was a big blow early on. Swing and a miss on a ball in the dirt, and it's strike one. This crowd, likely in the 40,000 range, they've got to like what they've seen so far.
Oh, and it's been a complete performance. They need to find a way to bottle this up and keep it going.
And smart to lay off there as the fastball misses. It's 1-2 now.
Not a real good 0-2 there. You don't necessarily want it in the zone, but you do want to at least give him something to think about.
Now a swing and a ball popped high in the air over toward foul ground. A quick out number one.
Yeah, a good pitch there as he gets the pop out on the fastball as we take a look at his pitch breakdown so far.
Cameron Maben steps in. He was able to reach base thanks to an error in his last at-bat. Hit hard on the ground to the right. Spin throw. The spin throw gets him at first. Nicely done for the second out.
A shortstop, number one,
Jose Iglesias gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Fly ball out toward left center field. And a dive out there in left center, but he can't come up with it. And he'll round it and try for third. And now third base coach Dave Clark's giving him the come on around third. And he gets there for the most exciting play in baseball, the inside the park home run.
Oh, those are fun to watch, especially sitting up here. We had a great view of this one, and you could see it developing pretty much right from the moment he touched first base. He's able to make it all the way around to score on the inside the park home run. Somebody get that guy some oxygen.
Here's the second baseman, Ian Kinsler. Hard liner toward short. And that may have had a bit too much on it as he can't knock it down. Around first, digging for two now. Kinsler's going to keep going. He's headed for third. And he'll barrel right through the stop sign, headed for the plate. And he'll get in there safely.
Something you don't see all that often. And it's still one of the most exciting plays in all of the game as far as I'm concerned. I was thinking that he might get held up at third, but he was having none of that. He had that inside the park home run on his mind from the get-go, and sure enough, he winds up getting it all.
Miguel Cabrera will stand in, and I've got to think these add-on runs here will really make it difficult to come back from.
And that's how they've done it all game long. They haven't really had a big inning yet, just a lot of ones and twos, but those will add up.
Lifted into center field. Moving under it, Fowler. And that ends the inning. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left. Kyle Schwarber will stand in to start out their half of the eighth with that starter still out there. And he's definitely been a tough nut to crack.
No, he's been dominant all game long. And I think part of it is that he got himself a nice lead early on. And that's allowed him to not really worry about making a mistake. He's been free and easy the whole way through.
Trying to strike him out for the second time. Launch to right field and deep. Back goes Martinez. A leap, and he's got it. Impressive play for the first down.
Well, this is really well done out there. I can't tell you how many times I've seen guys range back to the wall and then mistime that jump, but he tracks this all the way and winds up making a super catch.
Verlander into his motion. Here's the first pitch. Skied in the air to straightaway left. On the move is Upton. Oh, and this kicks right off of him. Around second now, heading for third. Oh, and he runs right through the stop sign. Tried to make it home when he shouldn't have, and now they've got him hung up. And he will come all the way around to score. Unbelievable. Anthony Rizzo stand in to keep things going. And I don't know, Steve, is the comeback on?
Well, at the very least, I like that they're showing some character out there. You never want to go down without a fight. So they're going to make these final at-bats count.
Runs up and gets this one down. And don't quite know what was going on there, but he's into first base safely. Ben Zobrist steps in with one in, one out, and one on here in the inning. And he tries to hold back on the swing, but I think it would have been ruled a strike anyway. It's nothing and one. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two. Verlander's starting to run up his pitch count. He's at 75 thus far. Oh, and two count. Here's the pitch. And a half-hearted attempt that time, but they'll say he broke the plane, and that's out number two.
Let's slow this down and check it out in slow motion. Does the bat wind up breaking the plane? Pretty close there. I think it could have gone either way, but the third base umpire says, yes, you did.
Here's Addison Russell. Runs up and gets this one down. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Now batting.
Number 40 steps in now. First pitch of the at-bat. And there's a fastball from Verlander to jump ahead 0-1.
Yeah, he was trying to do something dramatic right there, but when you think about it, at this point in the ball...
Threw it right past him, a swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Only one in the inning for the Cubs. Home half of the eighth. J.D. Martinez. Digs in to lead off the bottom of the eighth inning.
Right fielder,
into the windup and the pitch. And this is going to be a foul ball. On his way to pitch number 75. Hit in the air out to straightaway left. There to take it is Zobrist, and that's out number one.
The designated hitter, number 41, Victor Martinez.
Victor Martinez stands into the box. He could really use a knock here. 0 for 3 in the game so far. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And he goes against the shift there as this is on the ground to the left side. And a reach here, but this gets past him. And this one could be trouble. Around second. He'll try for third. Long throw to third. The tag, and he is called out trying to stretch two bases into three.
Well, once his ball got out there, you figured it was a sure double. But he decided to risk it and try for three. It's a pretty big gamble to take when you're already in scoring position, and here it doesn't pay off.
Nick Castellanos now, as he'll take a look at ball one.
And even though he's given up his share of hits so far, he still hasn't walked anybody, so at least he's got that going for him.
Well, should be 2-0, but he goes way out of the zone to go after that one, and it's even 1-1. Now a swing and a fly ball. Rizzo has room in foul territory, but no chance to run it down. It's a foul ball. Here's a high pop-up. Baez is there for it. Oh, and they botch this one as it drops in the infield. And he'll just slap the tag on the runner heading to second, and the inning is over. Stick around because Jason Hayward will lead things off when we come back. It's the Tigers 7 and the Cubs 2. Jason Hayward will start it off here in their half of the ninth, and no sign of a reliever. They're going to let him try to finish this one off.
Well, he's been brilliant so far, so why not see if he can take it the distance? It just doesn't happen these days very often.
Right by him here, and he's set up for another strikeout here. The count to 0-2.
Oh, you like the way this guy is just going about his business here. He's got a big lead, but he's pitching like it's a tie game here in the ninth.
At the plate, Javier Baez. His last at-bat didn't go his way as he popped out in foul territory.
Yeah, and I can guarantee you he wanted that swing back, too. He got a fastball to hit, and it seemed like he put a good swing on it, but he just missed it.
And they'll issue the intentional walk here. Interesting decision with the bases empty and one away. Dexter Fowler struggling so far in this one. He'll look to erase his 0-for-4 ball game with a base hit right here.
Oh, man, it's never fun to go 0-for, but let's see if he can find a way to climb out of it.
And here's a ball hit in the air. And no one will track it down. Think he held up in time, but that becomes moot as it's a called strike two.
Yeah, and it doesn't look like he's trying to get a ground ball here. He's coming right after him trying to get a punch out.
Struck him out as his woes continue as that's his third strikeout of the game.
Well, the strikeout pitch has certainly been there for him all afternoon, and this, in fact, is the third time he's victimized this guy.
And a rather interesting decision here as they'll put him on and move the runner into scoring position now.
I will say this, that's not a move you see very often. I've heard of managers going against the grain, but this is a strange one in my book.
Chris Bryant will stand in now, and hey, give these guys credit. They're not going down without a fight.
I'll tell you what, they're not too far away from making a game out of this one after all.
And a diving effort in center, but he can't get a glove on it. The run scores from second, around third, and being waved on home. And he will score as well. And a relay home. Throw won't get him. In now, Anthony Rizzo. He's 1-for-4 for the game. And there's a fastball from Verlander to jump ahead 0-1.
Getting that first pitch strike is so important against a guy like this. You have to be able to work ahead in the count and not let him dictate the at-bat.
And he'll round it and try for third. Well, he thought about going for third, and now that runner's in no man's land out there. And the offense continues as he's into third with a triple.
Yeah, and about the only drawback you have to having so many strikeouts is that it really runs that pitch count up. You can see on the graphic right here that that total's starting to get up there now, so he may be getting just a little bit tired.
So coming to the plate, Ben Zobrist. Although there are a couple of bases open, and we'll see if they think about working around him. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Chopped foul right at home plate at strike one. And one count and the pitch gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate, and he'll take first here on the intentional walk, so make it runners at the corners now with two away.
Now batting shortstop
Addison Russell stands in, the eighth man to bat in the inning, as he'll get a shot now with two on and two out.
Oh, this has been a very nice inning for them so far, but it still could get better.
And this is swung on and missed, so the Cubs are down to their final strike here.
And on the mound, you can tell he's not in here to mess around. He means business.
Has to be thinking strikeout here. Oh, and look out as this runs in and gets him. The second man he's plunked in this one.
Yeah, no way for him to be able to get out of the way of that.
And seeing as though he's the go-ahead run, probably wouldn't have tried too hard anyway.
Standing in now, number 40. As he'll swing and lift a foul ball off to the left and out of play. Swing, and he rockets this one down the left field line. And this gets down. Extra bases, and this could change everything. Rizzo scores. They will hold the other runner at third, but it's a two-run double, and it will tie up the ball game. But it is not in time as they take the lead here in the late going. Now a dive with the baseball as he makes the tag. Justin Upton will lead things off now in a completely different ballgame since the last time these guys took their hats.
And after that six-run inning, you got to hope that you can put together some kind of response. The last thing you want to do is a 1-2-3 inning, so a little patience wouldn't be the worst thing in the world.
Hot shot towards the hole, and this is through into right field, so the tying run's aboard to kick off the inning.
Oh, and it makes such a difference when that pitch is up a little bit. It's not a bad pitch, really. It's on the outside corner. But that slider is so much easier to handle when it's belt high or higher, and he's able to just hit it hard the other way.
Drilled to the right side. And that's in there for a base hit, his third hit of the game. And he'll just take the out at first here, which is a little surprising considering he had a good shot at two. So striding in, Cameron Maben, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. trying to hold the lead. Hit hard to the right side. Throw on to first takes care of Maben, and there are two away. So a pivotal moment here, and digging in now, Jose Iglesias, as he'll go to work on trying to bring home the tying run from third. The runner's breaking for home. Swing and a line drive, but foul. Two outs here with a runner at third. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. Now the runner breaks for the plate. And it may have been a straight steal of home, and it's going to pay off. Wow.
Well, the amazing thing about this steal of home was that with a right-handed pitcher on the mound, he should be looking at him the whole way. That's all about using the element of surprise there.
And a slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2. Swing, and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And Rizzo able to make the catch, and the inning is over. So this game will not end here in the bottom of the ninth as they push across the equalizer, and we're right back where we started from. Nine can't decide a winner. We'll move ahead to the tenth. Jason Hayward will start things off here as this topsy-turvy ball game heads for a 10th inning.
Well, both teams had a chance to win this thing in the ninth, and both bullpens faltered. And now here we are, wondering what's in store for us next.
Hit back up the middle, and that'll get through into center, so there's your possible go-ahead run on base now to lead off the inning. Javier Baez gets another crack right here. He's got a hit in three tries to this point. Chop foul at the plate, strike one. Ready with the nothing and one pitch. And I'm not sure, but it looks like he may have been blindfolded for that swing. It's 0-2 now. You guys surprised at all that that man doesn't have the bullpen going yet?
Well, he's showing a lot of faith in his starter, but to me, you've at least got to get someone stretching down there. Move him around a little bit.
Well, we've talked about it already, but this has just been an absolutely dominating performance out there. That's 14 strikeouts.
Here's Dexter Fowler now. And Verlander jumps ahead of him here with strike one.
And after three strikeouts already, you can bet he's going to be pressing up there at the plate, trying to make something happen. And that just might make things worse.
Possible go-ahead runs on first, one away. Out in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. Going for his 15th strikeout. Got him. And that's number 15 for the ballgame.
I'll tell you what, if you're related to this guy right now, you might want to turn away from the screen because this is going to be tough to watch. Here they are, one after another. That's four strikeouts for him, and that's called the Golden Sombrero.
Kyle Schwarber runs up as if to bunt and missed it. Strike one. Justin Wilson will take over here with the runner at first and two gone in the inning. Kyle Schwarber will be the first to greet him here as he stands in with the runner at first and two away. And here's a swing and a miss as he falls behind nothing and two.
That thing's coming in there hot.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. So nothing doing here after the six-run outburst the inning before. So 1-0. Into the box now, Ian Kinsler. And he made it exciting early on as he circled the bases with an inside-the-park home run his first time up.
Man, that was so much fun to watch. There's only a few moments in baseball that can be as exciting as an inside-the-parker.
He slaps that one away, and the count will be nothing and one. Swing and a miss, and he's in control, 0-2. rocket to third. But quick reactions at the hot corner take away a hit, and there's one gone.
First baseman, number 24, Miguel Cabrera.
Miguel Cabrera will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Hit high and deep to right center. Back goes Hayward. Still going back. Gone! Santa Maria! Game over! So a solo shot off the bat of Miguel Cabrera.